Hi, my name is Paige Rosner. I'm the gallery educator here at the Southern Alberta Art Gallery, and welcome to the 37th annual Arts Alive. Arts Alive and Well is a wonderful exhibition here at the SAAG. Every year we collect schoolwork from school children, kindergarten through grade 12, and we display it here in our main exhibition space. This opportunity is a heartfelt and very appreciated opportunity for kids to showcase their art in a proper professional gallery environment. Every year, we work with Phyllis Furukawa at Lethbridge School District 51 and a group of art representatives, wonderful art representatives from each school, to kind of select a certain number of pieces from each school depending on population of the school. We also work closely with the Holy Spirit Division to kind of bring the schools together in this wonderful submission process. Each art representative then brings the work to us and we display it here. And we also would not be able to do this without the help of all of these art representatives who come to the SAAG a week before the opening to help frame all of the artwork that you see hung on the wall. This is a huge undertaking and they come every year and they're devoted and they do an excellent job, so I couldn't be more happy about the work that teachers put in for this show. And it's a wonderful reminder of just how much work teachers do for our kids. I think it's clear that young artists in our community are inspired. The subject matter that they deal with, the ideas, the presentation and skill set that they offer us in these pieces is an inspiration. One of the most interesting things that I find every year with Arts Alive is how you have all of these random pieces of art that have come together without really any kind of discussion or without really any coordination, and somehow kids in the city are thinking and feeling and experimenting with the same things. So we have inherent themes each year that nobody expected and nobody kind of decided, and in fact it was really an organic creative process from the kids. When you first walk into the main exhibition space, you can't help but notice a fantastic, colorful explosion fest that was completed by the entire school of St. Pat's Fine Arts Elementary School. This is the wonderful explosion of color and a really interesting way of showing how when you do have a large school of children, that you can still come up with really interesting collaborative pieces of work that not only incorporate kind of the individualism of each student, but also the wonderful impact that a group of people can have together. And this is not only a wonderful lesson for the students to learn as they create this piece of art, it's also a really good and important lesson for us to remember when we think about, you know, what kind of role and what kind of impact children have today. Every year, a mural is submitted from a high school student, and this year we had the pleasure of receiving a mural created by Isadora Rodrigue from LCI. This piece deals with the notion of judgment and judging people before you get to know them. It's very much about seeing faces on the street in your life and attributing unjustified characteristics to them, both good and bad, based on kind of a visual appearance. And so she has a mural of almost floating heads, essentially, located in the portrait section of the gallery, and allows us to really think, who are the individual faces in this scene, and why do I feel the way I do about them? Arts Alive and Well is an institution in this community, and I myself was in Arts Alive once upon a time, and I know our assistant curator Christina was in Arts Alive as well, and a few of my other co-workers, so I distinctly remember it being a turning point in my life when my art was selected for Arts Alive, because it made me really feel validated in my creativity, and I felt as though maybe this was something that I could pursue in my future. So what this exhibition does for young artists is it goes beyond inspiring them to create art. It's a way of letting our kids know that we value what they're doing even now at a young age. This is by far one of my favorite times of year because this exhibition not only allows me to engage with more students, because we have tons of tours, at least 3 a day, coming through the exhibition to see not only their work, but to see the work of their peers, and to also be inspired by the young artists in their community who are their age. And that's one of the most important parts of this exhibition. Not only is it an opportunity to showcase work, but it's also an opportunity to inspire young kids to to know what they can be capable of doing if they really put in the time and the effort and if they really strive to create the best art that they can.